Securing that bullion robbery.
What?
The securing that bullion robbery.
Yes, what about it?
Major coup Bramoff, right? Five of them sent down for a grand total of 90 years.
Yeah?
Only one fly in the ointment, though.
What was that?
Only one fly.
Yeah. Yes, I knew that. What was the fly in the ointment?
10 million quid's worth of bullion stolen, right? Only 6 million recovered. Or to be exact, 10 million recovered and only 6 million goes back to the insurers. Someone's got very rich.
Who?
The investigation was headed by Chief Superintendent Barry Simmons.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. So you're suggesting Barry Simmons kept part of the stolen bullion?
All in one.
Can you prove this?
Yes.
How? What have you got?
I'll have to talk to Romney first.
Yeah, well, don't be too long about it. I haven't got any time for wild allegations. Now, can we get out of this room, please? I'm breathing air I used half an hour ago.
Hey, wait a minute.
What do you mean, wild allegations? You calling me a liar or something? What's going on? Trust him, Charles. He's like all the others, a sodding job's worth. They got you by the short and curlies just like everybody else, haven't they, Crabbe?
I'm going to need proof about Simmons, otherwise you're on your own.
Okay. Ken Bud Simmons' direct line at Beddingley Police Station for 12 months. He made recordings.
I'd like to hear one.
You will. I'll calm him down, don't worry. Hey, the guy just wants to be famous, just like everybody else.
Last orders were at 9, sir.
Oh.
They've closed the kitchen. Saved you some rolls. They're a bit weird, though. Stale on the outside and soggy on the inside.
Uh-huh. I thought as much. A small incision, the mark of the baker's chum, Cambridge.
Not with you, sir.
Never mind.
So, tell me about Shipley.
Definitely one sandwich short of a picnic. Picnics. God, I'm starving. Prawn cocktail mix. Keep away from naked flame. Aha! This must be the famous microwave. So, Chief Superintendent Barry Simmons makes off with 4 million quid's worth of stolen bullion. Seems highly unlikely to me.
In other words, you don't take Shipley seriously.
Freeze-dried mince granules. Quite. Shipley. No, he's like one of those people who thinks they've seen Elvis shopping in North Oxford. Aha! The most beautiful shape in nature. Somehow, real food has infiltrated this kitchen. Now all we need is some butter and a decent frying pan I can make as an omelette.
Good evening. Can I be of any assistance?
We're just looking around.
Guests are always welcome to inspect the kitchen.
Actually, I was going to make an omelette.
We'll pay for the egg, of course.
Fresh parsley. And chives. My own supply.
Well, now you're talking.
May I recommend a Beaujolais?
Indeed you may. It's my kind of guy.
Are you there?
It's Kent Shipley. We've got to talk.
This omelette, it's, I don't know, different. I can't explain it.
It's the crab effect.
What's that?
It's what happens when normally rational, articulate people eat his food. They get a faraway look in their eyes and start rambling.
You see, when it comes to omelettes, the heat of the pan is the crucial factor.
Okay, crab, stop messing about, shall we?
Oh, come on, ship. Look, can't you see we're eating? Sit down, relax, have a glass of wine. I'll tell you what, I'll make you an omelette.
Wild allegations, you said. Just listen to this. A telephone call between Simmons and a very senior police officer indeed.
It's Simmons, sir.
John?
Call me at home.
Do you think we could have another bottle of wine, please?
It's perfectly good, Simmons.
Ken!
Sorry, sir.
Ken, what's going on? Hey, we agreed. Nobody hears this material without signing a disclaimer.
Shh! I knew that voice.
Fisher.
Interested now,
eh? One of us will have to go to Switzerland.
Hi. Giles Romney, filmmaker.
PC Cambridge.
You're a policewoman. That's fabulous. I bet you've had a lot of problems with sexism and racism, eh?
When I first joined, yes. But I've mellowed a lot since then.
Shush!
I've got a 12-month option on the UK rights of this material, you know. Hey, what have you been eating? It smells great.
Nobody move! No. Stay away from that!
Crabbe, you bastard! You stitch me up!
Let me move!
You bastard, I'm trusting you! I'll get you for this! Anyone moves?
I'll let the dog off! The police are on their way!
We are the police, you Burke.
Shipley must have grabbed the tape. You'll be interested to know that we have been barred for life from the Nebditch Intercontinental Hotel and Conference Center.
What a pity.
Never believe how much they charge for 2 dozen eggs.
£30? Good God.
Mr. Fisher will have a fit when he sees it.
Good.
Shall we talk about the tape now, sir?
What tape?
It was you that took it, wasn't it, sir?
Can you give me a lift, Mr. Crabbe?
Of course, John. Where to?
Well, that's a bit of a problem.
Well, why is that, then?
Well, as a matter of fact, I'm no longer employed at the hotel.
Oh, no, not because of last night.
Well, there was a bit of a contretemps, yes.
Better jump in, then.
Seems that D.C. Shipley has been recording certain phone conversations from Beddingley Police Station.
My phone calls?
Yes, sir.
And you heard one of these recordings?
Well, I was about to, sir, when Mr. Simmons' men came barging. And of course, I had no idea who they were. And in the ensuing confusion, Shipley ran away.
And the tape?
Couldn't say, sir.
Couldn't say, eh, Crabbe? Well, let me tell you what Sergeant Millard says. Sergeant Millard says you caused the confusion in the kitchen, quite deliberately, in his opinion, so that Shipley could get away.
No, sir. No, see, I was making omelettes.
And as you know, when making omelettes, the heat of the pan is the crucial factor. And I was completely unfamiliar with the stove, do you see?
I believe this guy. He's talking about making omelettes.
All right, Barry. Give me 5 minutes with Inspector Crabbe, will you? This recorded phone conversation. Who was Simmons talking to?
I think it was you, sir.
And what was the nature of our conversation?
It wasn't possible for me to ascertain that, sir.
Crabbe, have you got that tape?
It shouldn't be necessary for you to ask that question, and I deeply resent the implications.